wanted to talk to you about simplicity today. And the reason I wanted to talk to you about simplicity is because it is so hard to find in these times. I think that it's a natural thing to, it would be a natural thing to have life, human life, be simple. Because really, humans are pretty simple all the time. And the lack of simplicity is what probably causes all the trouble. And there's a reason why there's a lack of simplicity, which I'll get to in a minute. Just that it's, I just want you to know that, I want you to recognize the fact that you already know that there's damn little simplicity in the world these days. Everything is complicated, complex and complicated, which is really, which seems to be the way it ought to be, but it's not, because human beings are really not very complicated. We have to eat, we have to sleep, we have to make a living, we have to, you know, take out the trash and be good at it or bad at it, all of it. If we're good at it, we can get better at it. And if we're bad at it, we can get better at it too. But the worship of, I don't know, what is the thing for not simple? The worship of the lack of simplicity is everywhere. And a lot of it has to do with the way the world works in these times of the internet and all of the things that seem to be so good to us, but seem also to be so bad to us too. The truth is, though, that whatever the cause of it is, in these times with us, uncertainty is the rule. We don't know what's going to happen. We hear about all the things that are going wrong in the world. We hear about all the horror that goes on in the world, and especially in this country, even more so than most countries. We have people killing each other for no reason at all, except for except for what causes all of the problems. The thing that causes all of the problems is fear. It's fear. And it's not fear that has any good reason for being here. I mean, if I step out in the road when a bus is coming, there's a good reason to be afraid of that. But nothing like that is happening for most of us all the time. The life is a human life, and a human life is really quite simple if you take it on its actual merits. It's not a big deal. You have to find a way to have work. You have to find a way to feed yourself. You have to find a way to satisfy your understanding of things, which is not a bad thing. Trying to understand why things are the way they are and so forth and so on. But all of that can be done simply. Uncertainty rules in this world. It's really the truth. None of us know what's going to happen. All of us are bombarded all the time of terrible things coming to pass, we're going to be in big trouble. Something's got to happen unless I get a gun, for example. Something's going to happen unless I get away from somebody or kill somebody or do something else. This is the uncertainty of life in these times in the human life, in the human being. Now, It's always been like that to a certain extent. It's not new, but the sheer magnitude and energy of it is getting consistently terrible. More, 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 more uncertainty, more fear, more wishing you had something else that you don't have. All of that is going crazy. And there's a reason for that. And the reason for that is that we are, all of us, stuck with a mind, minds that are filled with fear. And there may be, you know, two or three people around the world who have dodged that bullet, but for most of us, our minds are filled with fear. Our minds are given over to trying to find a way to get rid of the fear, really. Get rid of the fear. When people go into bars and shoot everybody, it's because they're trying to get rid of the fear. The fear is everywhere, everywhere. And that's the uncertainty, because there really is nothing to be afraid of other than the fear that is in our minds. That's the thing that we should be afraid of. And that's the thing that we should get rid of, because it has no bearing whatsoever. It is the cause of uncertainty. It is the cause of hatred and anxiety and self-destruction. The fear in our minds. Fear which has no reason for being there. We don't think of it as fear, because it's the whole of our mind. It is the consistent understanding of the mind is that there's something to be afraid of. And since it is made up in the first at all, there's nothing that you can do about it except try to get rid of it by, I don't know how you do it. You do it by taking on somebody else. You do it by blaming it on somebody else. You do it by blaming the world, blaming God, blaming anything. It's not you, it's them that is causing this. And this fear, this ever-present fearfulness in our minds, this complete uncertainty that comes from minds that are filled with trying to do something about the fear that is in them, that is the nature of your mind, pretty much. And that fear, that mental fear, is the cause of all human misery, heartache, and self-destructive actions that we see everywhere around. This is crazy. And it's all driven by fear.
So the cause is simple, too.
Yes.
Of all of it. It's very simple. It's one cause.
Right. One cause and to tell the truth, one cure. That's a fact. The reason for this, the only reason why this fear is a feature of human minds is really simple, and it's very simple and easy to understand. The reason for the arising of mental fear in the human being is birth. It's that simple. It is the horrifying nature of human birth. And I'm not going to get into trying to make you understand that. You can look it up yourself. You can think about it yourself and know that human birth sucks. Really does. We are premature when we're born. It's just terrible. Look it up. Look up about that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the cause. That's the only cause. So the reason I'm trying to get this over to you is because it's not your fault. It's not your fault that your mind is filled with fear. It has nothing to do with you. It's nothing you have done. It's nothing that you should not have done. It is simply the case that human birth creates minds, and probably not every single person, because some births are easier than others. But the vast majority of the minds of human beings are filled with fear, taken from that fearful beginning of our lives. And that's why. That's why the fear is there. And the fact that the fear is there is why everybody is batshit crazy. That's it. And so that it's not no big philosophical matter to it, no big spiritual matter to it. I'm not talking bad about philosophy or spirituality, but none of that has anything to do with the real problem that causes human beings to hate their lives and then try to pretend that they don't hate their lives. And then they try to pretend that you're the one that is the cause of the hating of your life. All of that just goes on. It has nothing to do with you. This mental fear is the cause of all human misery. It's not the cause of all things that happen to human beings that can be hurtful, or you can get killed, or you can get sick, or any of that. The fear isn't the cause of that, but the fear exacerbates it in a way that feeds it, so that everything that goes wrong in your life is food for the fear. It's the proof of the pudding in the mind.
Yeah. And it confirms that you really need to be scared and afraid all the time.
Yes, right. Yeah. Yeah. And we are afraid all the time. Mm-hmm. Again, there are a handful of people who haven't gone through this, but, you know, there's how many people in the world now?
More than 7 billion.
7 billion people in the world.
More. Now,
and maybe 15 of them dodged the bullet. And the rest of us are caught in the middle.
In varying degrees, right? In varying degrees.
In varying degrees. Mental fear is the cause of all human misery. Fear feeds on complication. Anything that's complicated, anything that takes a moment to figure out is fearful. And has to be done because of the fearful nature of it. If you don't know something, you're afraid. You have to be afraid so that you can get to know what you need to know. If you don't want anything, again, you have to be fearful. That's the energy that allows you to try to get through the day, and for good or for bad. Fear also feeds on double talk. One moment, the mind says, oh, you got to be afraid of that. And then the next moment, it says, oh, you got to embrace that. That goes on all the time, as long as you're awake, and for most of us, also even when we're asleep. That dance.
A debate.
That debate, right. The dance of that debate. It goes on all the time. Oh, that's okay. No, it's not okay. Can't be okay because of that. But wait a minute, what about that? Oh, that'll be okay, but it's not enough. It's not gonna help me in the way I need to be helped. I'm still gonna be batshit crazy and hating my life. That's what goes on. And that fear is everywhere. 7 billion people, give or take, every single one of us are cooked in fearfulness. Our minds are filled with fear. And the one thing that is really the terrible thing about it is that we don't see it as fear, even. It's just the nature of things. And
it's cumulative, right? It just
And it's cumulative.
You were saying that the reason for all of this is very simple, is the fear.
Yeah.
So what's the solution?
The solution is to look at yourself. That's the solution. And the reason that's the solution is because when you take that first look at yourself in the manner that we offer to you, which is extremely simple, it doesn't take anything but a couple of seconds to try to get a taste of what it actually feels like to be you outside of the mental agony. Just that, just you. And I tell you, that's all you have to do. That really is all you have to do. It's not going to get completely better all quickly, but from the very first time that you get a taste of what it actually feels like to be you without the fear, when you get a taste of that, the show is over. It takes a while for it to wind down, but the show is over. And we have thousands of people who have done nothing more than this simple act of looking at yourself. And many of them come back and tell us how grateful they are for what we have given them and how crazy it is that it's so simple. There's nothing more that you have to do. Absolutely nothing more. Take 5 years or so, but that 5 years is always getting better.
It's all
no getting worse.
It's 5 years of revelation, real learning and discovering.
Yes, right.
More about yourself, and not necessarily 5 years either. I mean, it can be less. It varies, right? Yeah, but a couple of years.
10 years, but I think that there's a big enough mass now of people who have done that it has been. We now know that it's been cut down to about 5 years. And maybe less than
maybe
that.
Maybe less, yeah.
Yeah.
As more people look and get free of fear, this spreads. And it seems that it also gets to be faster, yes. It's
oh, yeah, sure.
And, the air
less,
and
less, there's a little less fear in the world.
Yeah.
See, that's what happens. There's a little less fear in the world. And people, therefore, now are getting to the point where maybe 5 years, but it's not a 5 years where you're miserable for 5 years. It's a 5 years in which you become accustomed to your natural mental states and accustomed to be grateful for it.
Yeah.
Instead of
to be in this,
wishing it was else.
This natural state of being,
yeah,
which is free of fear.
The only thing that has to be done, I tell you this from my heart, and is that you look at yourself in the way we speak. And maybe you could do that now, even if you've done it 100 times. Maybe you could do that now.
I like to close my eyes and try to feel what it feels like to be me without trying to answer the question or trying to find a word to define. It's no words, it's wordless, it's just the sensation, the feeling of it.
That's it.
With your inner eye, your attention turned inward.
Okay. There are other things that you can learn to do when you have control over your mind, but those are not for this particular webinar. The most important thing is to have the fear that causes you all of the misery start to leave. And if you have looked now or before now, it is already starting to leave. If you've looked a while back, it's probably you probably have noticed that things are changing in your mind. And this is not magic. This is not religion. This is not anything other than the misery of human beings and the reality that human beings can put an end to that. The same human beings that are killing people and hating people and all of that, they all can be changed. They can be changed quickly if they can hear this and if they can do what we ask them to do. Doesn't matter who it is. Doesn't matter how terrible they have been in their life. God knows I have some terrible stuff in my life.
In the past.
And I'm the one, of all the people I know, I am the one that is the least likely to have found this and be able to get rid of the fear in my own mind. But I tell you, when it's gone, it's gone. It doesn't come back. It'll never come back.
Maybe we could talk about a few examples of how you start how you notice changes. What kinds of changes are those that you can notice in your life? Once when the fear leaves and the mind starts rearranging itself. For instance, certain behaviors that you have in a particular situation, you're used to having a certain reaction, and then the situation appears and they notice that, well, I didn't have that reaction. Like a concrete example, we had somebody write and say, you know, I used to go on stage and I would be a musician really anxious. That's the reaction. And then this person noticed after a while that that's not that response, automatic response, was not happening anymore. And many others, right?
Yes, it's
mostly behaviors and mental reactions and trains of thought that start kind of falling apart and not appearing anymore.
Yeah, and the sheer mass of bogus fear in the mind, as it starts to go, it will accelerate as time goes on. The fewer instances of that fearfulness, the less food there is for the rest, what remains.
And those instances that we're talking about are these mental mechanisms that run the show, like algorithms in the mind. If this happens, I think this. If that happens, I do this. If this happens, I feel that, right? That's those mechanisms that start to fade away. And as this leaves, it's like all this energy that's been spent paying attention to the fearfulness, etc., it's freed, right? There's a lot more mental energy available.
Yes.
To good stuff, to learn, to be more effective.
In your life.
Yeah.
Human life turns out to be, well, not easy, you know? I mean, it's not, humans don't have an easy life, but it doesn't have to be a life that is destroyed by fear. There's nothing but fear that causes this trouble. Nothing else. We work, we do what we can, we make mistakes, we make good things, just like anybody else. There's no magic in it. So what you end up with is being a human being without the yoke of fear to have to drag around.
But this fear is like an existential fear, right? We're not talking about fearful situations when you are in danger. That fear is useful.
Yeah.
But this fear is this fear where I am at stake in everything I think and everything I do, right? If I don't do the right thing, I'm going to die. And it's like irrational.
Yeah,
right? Yes. Or pre-rational.
Pre-rational. Yeah, and that's a good insight. It's not like you don't see the fear come in. The fear started at birth from the very beginning.
It's the context, right? It's the context of the mind. It's a mental environment that's based on a fearful relationship with life.
Right. And so as you grow older, as you're no longer a child and things and so forth, the mind gets better at trying to understand what's happening to you. And that trying to understand what's happening to you is controlled by fear. This is the thing about it that is really the hardest thing to grok. And that is that it's simple. It is so simple. You don't have to know anything about it. You don't have to believe in it. You don't have to do anything. All you have to do is look at yourself one time. You probably will do it. If you do it one time, you'll probably do it more times, and that's okay too.
This fear is more like on the level of neurosis and that kind of stuff. Unjustified, although we come up with explanations and rationalizations to explain it, and that's the part of that double talk you were talking about.
Here's the thing. I can talk to you folks here, and you can listen to me and understand what I'm saying, and you can do the looking again if you choose to. But the other part of this is the rest of the world, the 7 billion people who are running on fear all the time, everywhere. And if I, like, for example, the stupid fear is pretty much gone for me. And I have to tell you that when the stupid fear is gone, there's not much going on in the mind. It's very quiet. It's not something that where I worry about it or think about it or, you know, try to understand it or anything like that. Once it's gone, it's gone. And what you have is a kind of an empty mind until something comes to it that is worth thinking about.
It's like a spacious mind.
Spacious mind.
Plenty of space.
Right, plenty of space. But and this is the hard part. All of those other people, all of those human beings, it takes so little. If we could drop the just one look method from airplanes with parachutes, I would do it because it doesn't take anything. If we could just get the word out to everybody that needs it, things would change.
It would start changing.
Miraculously. It would change miraculously. I could tell that because my own mind changed miraculously. And my mind was really not very good.
Mine too. Yeah.
Yeah. And when that happens, when people start seeing it in good numbers, you know, like millions of them, not the whole world, but if we just get millions of them that get free of the fear, those millions themselves will be seen by the people and be talking about. So how do we do that? Anybody there have an idea as to how we can get that done? Okay. Thanks again. See you next time. Let us know how you're doing. Always let us know. Everybody here, let us know how you're doing. That's very important to us.